I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America.
And to the republic for which it stands,
one nation, under God, indivisible,
with liberty and justice for all.
Good morning, Frontier. I'm Dan Demon, and this is your Friday Morning School News. Today we'll be talking about many things such as Valentine's Day, Black History Month, international news, and winter sports. Quote of the day is, be the person your dog thinks you are. This is my dog, Bucky. He's a really good boy. Have a nice day, Frontier.
What up, folks? I'm back. So, anyway, let me get to this important story. There were people who were trapped from a Himalayan glacier who broke off and set a wall of debris and water rushing down a mountain in a disaster that had left over 26 people dead, 165 missing. More than 36 power plant workers were trapped in a tunnel. And then more than 2,000 members of military and groups and police officers who've been taking part in search and rescue options up in the northern state of India after the flood, which destroyed one dam, damaged another, washed away homes. Officials said the focus was on saving 37 people and workers who were stuck inside a tunnel at one of the affected hydro power plants. Heavy equipment was brought in to help clear the way through.
Oh, welcome back, everybody, to your favorite section of the news. What is going on? All right, let's have a look-see, shall we? So, minimum wage went up from $12.75 to $13.50. Go out and get some bread, all right? Everybody. So, Biden claims, all right, get this. Stimulus checks, they're going up to $1,400. What else? Let's see. New microphone.
What's up, guys? It's Aiden Roach here with the little Frontier Sports update. Last night, both boys and girls basketball, tough losses to Marhar. A couple close games. Both teams looking to rebound this afternoon, like, with their games against Athol. Boys will be live streamed on FCAT, so make sure to check that out. Last night, Greenfield Hockey Co-op, big 9-2 win over Southwick. Their next game will be this Saturday at 6:30 against South Hadley, also an FCAT. So be sure to tune into that and support the teams.
My name's Eva. I'm a sophomore, and over February break, I think I'm just going to log some driving hours with my parents because I have my learner's permit. I'm probably going to catch up on some schoolwork and, yeah, just hang out, get a lot of sleep.
My goal over February break is to not shovel snow, and that's what I'll be doing, avoiding any work.
Hi, I'm Miss Milliken. I will be doing some schoolwork, sleeping, and going for a few hikes.
Hey, so this February break, I hope to get on my fat mountain bike. Yeah, that's a fat bike with big wheels, and get on the trails. Very good biking right now when the snow is all packed down, real nice. I also have some projects, video projects that I'm going to take care of, including two varsity basketball games and a hockey game. Or two hockey games. So, yeah, that's what I'm doing with my time.
Hello, my name is Annalise Apt, and for this February break, I'm probably going to go skiing with my family. Hello. And that's it. Stay tuned next time.
My philosophy is very simple. When you see something that is not right, not fair, not just, say something, do something. Get in trouble, good trouble, necessary trouble.
He was always different than every member of Congress. Everybody knew what he had done. He was John Lewis.
We're marching today to dramatize to the world that hundreds and thousands of Negro citizens denied the right to vote.
Congressman Lewis gave us the blueprint to organize and to legislate.
The reason why he's effective as a leader is because he's lived it.
He brought honor to disobedience.
I suggest you look outside that window.
You've been laying down and bowing down for 400 years. I think it's time to stand up.
All right, break it up. You got what you wanted.
Nah, I'm not satisfied.
That's too much power for one man to have.
And a voice to a people who longed to be heard.
You've been hoodwinked, bamboozled, led astray.
You're saying you're anti-white.
No, you're saying I'm anti-white.
I'm sorry, Betty. I haven't been the best husband.
Shh, I love you.
Do you advocate violence?
No, sir.
Denzel Washington's most electrifying performance. Director Spike Lee's most powerful film.
Malcolm, can we all live together?
I sincerely hope so.
I am from the south side of Chicago.
That tells you as much about me as you need to know.
It was a typical working class community.
Some good music, some good barbecue, some good times.
She's just a girl and she's on fire.
So little of who I am happened in those 8 years. So much more of who I was happened before.
In high school,
your guidance counselor didn't see in you what you saw in yourself. Yeah.
She decided I was reaching too high.
How did you, as a black woman, persevere?
We can't afford to wait for the world to be equal, to start feeling seen. I feel like I gotta share with you all that the energy that's out there is much better than what we see.
How's everybody doing?
This girl is on fire.
We don't do what we love, then we wouldn't exist.
It's time, kid.
It's like nothing really matters to him right now, including me.
You gotta think real hard about this. You got people that need you now.
I'm taking the fight.
And when I stepped in that ring, it wasn't all about me.
It is America's music. Born out of a million American negotiations. Between having and not having, between happy and sad, country and city, between black and white, and men and women, between the old Africa and the old Europe, that could only have happened in an entirely new world. It is an improvisational art, making itself up as it goes along. Just like the country that gave it birth. It rewards individual expression, but demands selfless collaboration. It is forever changing, but nearly always rooted in the blues. It has a rich tradition and its own rules, making things simple, dressing to the nines. It has enjoyed huge popularity and survived hard times. But it has always reflected Americans, all Americans, at their best. Jazz, the drummer Art Blakey liked to say, washes away the dust of everyday life. Above all, it swings.
Y'all gonna end up unemployed riding around in this pile of junk.
You're welcome to walk the 16 mile.
Or sit in the back of the bus. Like
you have identification number?
NASA, sir.
NASA? I had no idea they hired it.
There are quite a few women working in the space program.
Least I can do is give y'all an escort.
In 14 days, astronauts will be here for training. And we're shooting a human into space, and it's never been done before.
With the launch of the Russian spy satellite, the president is demanding an immediate response. Running from the
man. Space test group needs a computer.
Catherine's the gal for that. She can handle any numbers you put in front of her. My gals are ready. We can do the work.
More than 50 million Americans watching.
On this week's news. Come back next week for more local, national, and worldwide news. Coming up next week, we do have February break, so look forward to that. And have a good rest of your day.
And now we've got Leo with Valentine's Day updates. Have a good week, everybody.
Greetings, Frontier Regional. My name's Leonardo Franceschi. I am, as does some people call me, the CEO of Love, and I'm here to give you the Valentine's Day report, special update. I wrote this Valentine for you and especially you, and it reads, Happy Valentine's Day. Roses are red, violets are blue. I love Frontier, and I love you too. So that is the Valentine that I wrote for you. Announcement, Valentine's Day is happening this Sunday, February 14th. And after that, on Monday, we got President's Day coming up. I'll read you a fun fact about a president right now. Lyndon Baines Johnson. On November 8th, 1966, in the midterm election, the Republicans gave 3 more seats in the Senate and 47 more in the House of Representatives. That's a fun fact about the presidents that happened during Lyndon Baines Johnson's term. President's Day, we got Mardi Gras coming up, Fat Tuesday on Tuesday, and I hope you guys have a fantastic break full of fantastic holidays. Thank you very much. This is Leo, the CEO of Love, heading out. Peace.
Whatever they be. Happy Valentine's Day. Every day the 14th. I don't think y'all heard me. I just wanna say Happy Valentine's Day.